This is Monica, and you're watching Frequency TV.
Every night I'm wishing, hoping that it's only getting closer, 'cause
there was no fear. When I look at my life experiences, I know that I don't walk this walk alone. I respect the fact that music has changed. Even when things get tough, you gotta walk by faith and not by sight. A lot of my poems have become songs. They are only different because in songs, you need for things to be repeated. Being repetitive in song is very good because it resonates. In poems, you look for things to be strong and for them to stand alone. So it's been kind of easy for us to change my poems into actual songs and lyrics because they have these underlining things that are exactly alike with these two huge differences. I'm no different when the cameras are off. With the exception of hair and makeup, it's all the same. I didn't create this facade that I had to try and keep up because I was always just being me. That was all that I knew. People are very judgmental, and it makes artists more afraid of just being them. But when you make no apologies for being who you are, you can always stay connected to your audience. There are no two separate people from Monica the artist and Monica the person. I am a very emotional person. That can be both good and bad, but I am extremely emotional. I don't ever want to lose the fact that it's okay to me to cry. It's okay to me to laugh. It's okay to be silly. It's okay to have a good time. And it's okay to stand up for what you believe in. You should be comfortable with your own reflection. And that's a reflection of the inside and the outside. And think of a song that I did called Mirror. And it basically says, when I look at myself in the mirror, I don't have to be ashamed. Now I'm seeing things much clearer. I'll never be alone again. And what that says is, if I can be there for me and accept me and believe in me and trust in me, then it'll be easier for other people to do as well. My ultimate prize is self-acceptance and just recognizing that no matter what takes place in my life, it's my journey, it's my life, it's my story. I have to embrace it and love it. Really wanted to become a homicide detective, and strangely enough, I still do. I went before the state of Georgia to see if they would allow me to really pursue my career, and because of the music side of it all, I wasn't able to give them enough hours. An officer that's a really good friend of mine said, well, you need to really take some time and come out and see what it is we experience. They allowed me to be a part of it and see how all the forensic of it works. And when he said, if you can stomach this, you definitely could do it. So I have not totally turned my back on finding some way to be a part of it, because that's something that's very serious. I would never partially do it. So if I ever decide to take another one of my 4 or 5 years off, it may just be what I'll be doing. One of my newest endeavors that have been really fun for me has been my nail polish line. And Nail Inspirations is basically when you open up the box, you get an inspirational quote that I've written. Different shades can make you think of different things. I'm passionate about it, so I could do it forever. And what I mean when I say that is, I want to sing forever. So I want to always do things and be a part of things that mean a lot to me. My husband and I are opening a funeral home. As strange as that all sounds, I grew up in one. I looked at it very differently. I looked at it and I saw families that were hurting, and my stepfather's a minister, so he was always bringing comfort. And so I look at it as a way to bring comfort in some of people's darkest hours. The things that I've stepped into as far as me being an entrepreneur are very different. They're very abstract, but they're all things that I love. I don't even respond to what's even said about me, because to me, the truth really doesn't need any support. It eventually tells itself. I've also acknowledged that people creating stories is sometimes just a way for them to live. It's a way to make money. It's a way to feed their families. And I accept that taking a forum as public as this one and being an artist will come with challenges. My grandmother used to always tell me, to whom much is given, much is going to be required, so be prepared. I want people to walk away with a sense of strength, a great reminder of faith, and belief in self when they listen to New Life. If you have those three things, I think you can weather any storm. Michael Jackson, Whitney Houston, Kenny Rogers, Dolly Parton. I love to cook. my grandmother. Heaven is a peaceful place, a place where we all go to rest after this earthly life is over. But the ideal that I'm working towards, being a part of heaven and seeing and being reunited with the people that I loved and lost, is enough reason for me to live right. My kids. Before I die, I'd like to see all of my children happily married, successful, and all of their goals and aspirations are reached. Please don't let me leave before that happens. This is Monica, and you're watching Frequency TV on your favorite Radio 1 website.